Today we will study about trigonometry. It's a branch of mathematics, and I'm using laser printer. Here we are going to study about the triangle measurement, the sides, angles in a triangle. A circle was divided into 360 degrees, and the circle was used to measure the triangle measurement. Sine was invented in India in 400 AD. The relation between sides, the angle of a triangle, are some of the things which we'll study basically in the first stage. The application of trigonometry is wherever higher mathematics are involved in surveying, navigation, etc. Here you see that there is a x-axis and y-axis. Ox is called the ray. This Ox can be rotated anti-clockwise. This is called a terminal. And as it moves anti-clockwise, then there is an angle theta is measured in two angles. This is positive direction. So theta is positive. We will see the angle theta is the amount of rotation of a revolving line from initial position to terminal position. What is the initial position? Ox is the initial position. Positive x-axis is the initial position. And from where we are measuring, positive direction is anti-clockwise. Counterclockwise, both are same. And clockwise is negative. That is, if you are going downwards, then it is negative. A rotating ray with its end point at the origin is called the terminal side of a rotating line. Please note, O is a fixed, is hinged, I would say. So the Ox can be rotated, that's called the terminal, right? The terminal side of a rotating line. It is a rotating ray because it can be extended to any length up to infinity. The positive off of the x-axis is called initial side. This Ox here is positive side of the x-axis is called the initial side. And this is called terminal side. One complete rotation counterclockwise is called 360 degrees. If it goes round and comes back to the initial position, that means we are rotated 360 degrees. So if I divide it to 4, then this one quarter is called 90 degrees. And this another quarter, 90 degrees. This quarter, 90 degrees. So we call it as a perpendicular. If it is 90 degrees, then the lines are perpendicular. If there is no rotation, then it is 0 degrees. So the Ox measures an angle of 0 degree as well as 360 degrees. So afterwards, any rotation gives you an angle that can be converted into a theta value less than 360. Because after 360, again, it comes to 0. And then 362 is nothing but 2 degrees. And 720 means two rotations it has completed and comes back to 0 degrees. So that it will come back to 0 degree, 90 degree, 180 degree and 270 degree often. Because any number more than 360 degree can be reduced to a number less than 360 degrees. Okay. Now angle measurement. If the rotation is 1/60th of one complete rotation, then the angle is 1 degree. Right? Please note there is a zero upper superscript. No, that means degree, it is in degree. Otherwise, if theta is given just like that without this upper superscript, then it is in radians. Okay, we will see what is radians later. 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes, and 1 minute is 60 seconds. So 1/60th of complete rotation is 1 degree, and 1/60th of that is 1 degree, 1 minute. And 1/60th of that is 1 second. So in theoretical work, another system of measurement of angles, that is circular measure, this is called radian, is taken as the unit of measurement. We will see what is radians. See, radius, ratio of a circumference of a circle to its diameter is a constant. This constant is obtained to be pi, that is 22/7. Actually, the constant is 2 pi. And then 2 we know very well the number, therefore pi is the constant used, and it is an irrational number. You know what is an irrational number? We cannot be put in the form of a 22/7. So this is an approximation. Okay. The angle formed by one complete revolution of the initial side is equal to 2 pi. Therefore 2 pi radians is equal to 360 degrees. So the angle formed by one complete revolution of the O is missing here. Sorry. Right. Now, length of an arc of a radius r subtended by an angle theta radians is L is equal to r theta. We will see it in the next slide about this more. So we know what is 2 pi. One complete rotation means the angle rotated is 2 pi radians, which is 360 degrees. So 2 pi is equal to 360s. And Pi by 2 also we will be using. Pi by 2 is 1.57. You remember that? We will see in a graph, I will represent 1.57, which is nothing but pi by 2. Now see here, this is the diameter. Radius, twice radius is diameter. And if I draw a circle, then the circumference will be 2 pi r. The ratio of this to this is pi. So 2 pi r by 2 r is pi. That is a constant. So theta is equal to 2 theta is equal to this particular rotations. Then we can find out the arc length. Because if it is 2 pi, it is 2 pi r. If it is this much theta, then theta by pi. Circumference constant, which is diameter. Diameter is equal to twice the radius. Right? Constant is equal to 2 pi r by 2 r. So circumference is equal to a constant into diameter. And therefore, diameter we know 2 r. Therefore, the constant we are obtaining by the by dividing the circumference by the diameter. 2 pi r by 2 r is the pi. So now we know the theta into r is the arc. If theta is equal to 2 pi, the circumference is 2 pi r. Understand? So if theta is some x value, so x into in radians, please note it must not be in degrees. So because this 2 pi is in radians, you know, right? So if the angle is 2 pi, the circumference is, the arc of the complete circle is, arc length of the complete circle is 2 pi r. Right? Therefore, if the angle is theta radians, then the arc length is given directly, just like multiplying r, the radius, by the radians, theta radians, right? Okay. Now we will see that thing. Circular functions, we will see what are all the circular functions. This trigonometric functions are also called circular functions. It's a ratio. Even though we say it's a ratio, the ratios are all same. And therefore, we can take a point anywhere on this ray. And then we'll find out. We will form a triangle. And then use the circular functions, find the circular functions. So please note, you may think that because you are using a triangle here, so the sides are very important to find the trigonometric ratios. It's not so, right? It's only a function of theta. The trigonometric functions are dependent only upon theta, not upon the sides, right? It's a beauty. We will see that now. Trigonometric ratios. Consider an angle subtended by the terminal side OC. This is the terminal side, right? Consider a point P on that. Let OX be the initial side and theta be the angle, that is the angle rotated anti-clockwise, which is positive, and P, X, Y be the any point. X, Y means this length is X and this length is Y. That is, horizontal length is X, vertical length is Y. It makes 90 degrees. The trigonometric ratios are a function of theta only. We will see that how, right? Because sine theta is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. Opposite side by hypotenuse. Please note, this is always positive. What? Because it is measured from the center outwards. So inwards is negative, outwards is positive. So since we are measuring from the center always, R is positive. Wherever R is there. In the first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant, R is positive. But the X and Y coordinates change directions. When R is in the second quadrant, what is negative? X coordinate is negative. Y coordinate is positive. When it is in the third quadrant, when R is in the third quadrant, then both X and Y are negative. When it is in the fourth quadrant, the X is positive, but Y coordinate is negative. Right? Y coordinate is negative. So we'll have to see. Therefore, sine theta is equal to Y by R, cos theta is equal to X by R, and tan theta is equal to Y by X. Right? Tan theta is equal to, this is the definitions, based on the definitions. When theta is not equal to pi by 2, tan theta is equal to y by x. Why? When theta is equal to pi by 2, what will happen? When theta is equal to pi by 2, 90 degrees, right? Okay. Then y by x will be 0. So you can't divide by 0, no? Because undefined. Therefore, when theta is equal to pi by 2, tan theta is not defined. Understand? So, similarly, cosecant theta. What is cosecant theta? Is 1 by sine theta. It's defined. And secant theta is 1 by cos theta. Cos right? 1 by cos theta. So cosecant theta is equal to r by y is not defined when theta is equal to 0. Please note, sin theta and cos theta is defined throughout. Understand? For any angle, it is measured. But the other angles are not measured for or not defined for a particular theta value. That is what we are obtaining here. Secant theta is equal to r by x. So 1 by cos. Right? When x is equal to 0, 1 by 0, it's undefined. Therefore, at pi by 2, it is not defined. Right? At theta is equal to 0, cot is not defined. Okay? Because tan is not defined, therefore, here cot is equal to x by y. Right? X by y. When theta is equal to 0, what happens? Y is 0. When theta is equal to 0, y is 0. When theta is equal to pi by 2, x is 0. Therefore, this relations come. Go through that. This note down in your piece of paper. And then check with this what happens. The y value is 0 when theta is equal to 0. X value is 0 when theta is equal to pi by 2. Y is equal to 0 when theta is equal to 0. When theta is equal to pi by 2, x is 0. Therefore, at those points, it is not defined. For the rest of the theta values, it is defined. Yeah. Now, we will see that. Why it is a function of only theta there, the circular ratios, we will see here. Because I consider two points P and P dash. So we draw a vertical here, and then PM is the Y, and then OM is X. So sine theta is equal to opposite side by adjacent, opposite side by hypotenuse. So either PM by OP or P dash M dash by OP dash. But PM by OP is equal to P dash M dash by OP dash by the similarity of the triangles. Okay. Corresponding angles are corresponding sides opposite to corresponding angle are proportional. Okay. Right. For the, it is PM is also opposite theta, P dash M dash is opposite theta. Therefore, this ratio of these two is equal to the ratio of these two, because this is proportional to this, this is proportional to this, the same ratio. Therefore, it's a constant, right? So, whatever be the point on this ray, the sine theta, cos theta, the functions that we have defined so far is a function of this angle of rotation only, not the position of the point on the ray, right? Now, the trigonometric ratios are a function of theta only. That is what we said. They do not depend on the position of P on the terminal side. That also I have explained. If the terminal side coincides with the x-axis, then cosecant cot are not defined. We know why. Right? Okay. And then if the terminal side coincides with y-axis, then secant and tan are not defined. Because at pi by 2, the denominator becomes 0. Okay. When it coincides with x-axis, the denominator x y becomes 0. Therefore, it is not defined. Okay. When it is coinciding with x-axis, y is 0. When the terminal side coincides with y-axis, x is 0, which becomes the denominator for these two functions. Why? Because the division is undefined. We will stop with this. We will see more on the sine theta, cos theta, and tan theta, how it is repeating. So sine theta is equal to sine of theta plus 2 pi. Because one rotation, after one rotation, it comes back to theta. Therefore, sine theta is equal to sine theta plus 2 pi. Similarly, cos theta is equal to cos theta plus 2 pi. So any angle if you take tan theta is equal to tan theta plus 2 pi, it's in radians. Please note, theta, there is no upper zero is there. No, there is no, if there is zero, then it should be not 2 pi, it should be 360 degrees. Right? Theta degree plus 360 degree or theta plus 2 pi. Both are same. One is in radians, another is in degrees. This is in radians, right? So all these trigonometric ratios, sine, cos, and tan are repeated after 2 pi rotations, 360 degree rotations. So it is varying from only 1 to minus 1, minus 1 to 1. That we will see that later. And sine of minus theta is equal to minus sine theta. We will see why here sine of theta is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is the radial distance, which is always positive. Here, the denominator becomes negative when theta is minus. Therefore, it becomes negative. Sine theta becomes negative. So, minus of minus becomes positive. Therefore, sine of minus theta is equal to minus sine theta, which we will see here. Similarly, tan theta also. tan of minus theta is equal to minus tan theta. If function of minus x is equal to minus function x, then this is called odd function. Therefore, sine and tan are odd functions. But cos theta, my cos of minus theta and cos theta are same. Therefore, this is an even function, right? We'll see here. We need to know only one half of the graph to complete the rest. Because if you know from x-axis positive direction to x-axis minus direction, that is upper off. If you know the upper off, we will know the lower off, right? One half only we know theta greater than zero. Then another half we will always be able to find out. It depends upon the function, sine and cos. We will see that what. For sine, it is 0 to 2 pi. And then for cos, it is minus pi to pi. And for tan, it is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. We'll see here. Now, the plot we will see here, 0 to 2 pi, we are drawing sine function and cos function. So when sine 0 is 0, so this red is sine, we know cos 0 is 1, that's what blue is cos function. And the cycle is 1 cycle in 2 pi. So cycle period is 2 pi. Understood? So this is a cos function. And at cos pi, it is minus 1, right? That is, what is pi? 180 degrees, right? And 0. 0, pi and 2 pi. 2 pi and 0 are same. So at 0 and pi radians, the cos is 0. And pi by 2 and 3 pi by 2, this blue, cos is 0. And at 0 and pi, and 0 and 2 pi are same, right? At 0 and pi, sine is 0. So cos inverse and sine inverse, we will see here, same thing. See, I told you, 1.57, it is pi by 2, right? When cos pi by 2 is, right? Cos pi by 2 is 0, right? Cos pi by 2 is 0. Cos 0 is 1. Cos 0 is 1, right? So cos 0 is 1. We will see here. So cos 0 is 1. So when 1 is equal to 0, cos is 0, right? Angle is 0, right? Okay. When pi by 2, it is 0. Cos inverse of 0 is pi by 2. Cos inverse of pi by 2 is 0 is pi by 2, which is pi by 2 is 1.57. Understand? Right? What is cos pi by 2? Cos pi by 2 is 0. So cos inverse of 0 is pi by 2. Understand? Okay. So similarly, what is sine pi by 2? 1. So sine pi by 2, sine inverse of pi by 2 is, sine inverse of 1 is pi by 2. Since pi by 2 is sine 0 is 0, sine inverse of 0 is 0. Therefore, this is red is sine inverse function. Please note, see the function here. Oh, we are not seeing here, right? Yeah, see, cos function and sine function. What is cos? Cos 0 is 1. So cos inverse of 1 is equal to, should be 0. That is all single. Cos inverse of 1 is equal to 0, right? Cos inverse of 1 is equal to 0. X-axis is the y-axis. Understand? So I have used this because pi by 2 and all are not coming in my graph sheet. That's why. So we will see here now. So theta goes anyway, right? This angle is theta. Sorry, this arrow is not correct. Here also there should be an arrow. That's all. Right? So we know a unit circle is what we will take because it is independent of the ray, you know. So any ray we can do and then do the same thing. But for convenience, I will take only a unit radius. Unit radius means the radius is 1. Right? So the radius R is always 1. R is always 1. Right? Because the radius is 1. And when it is coinciding with the positive x-axis, that is initial line, initial ray, I would say that. Then the coordinate of this point on the circle is 1, 0. X is equal to 1. Y is no position 0. And when it comes to pi by 2 position, then y is equal to 1 and x is equal to 0. Right? I will see that probably if I take... And then this becomes 0, comma 1. This becomes minus 1, comma 0. And then this becomes 0, comma minus 1. Right. Therefore, you will see that it varies only from 0 to minus 1 to 1. Minus 1 to 1. Okay. Understand? So, the minus 1 and 1 are the limits. Therefore, for all theta, then we, what we will do is the circular functions varies from minus 1 to 1. Minus 1 to 1. The range is only minus 1 to 1. But what is the domain? Domain is, can be anything, minus infinity to plus infinity, right? If I start this as 0 degrees, then if I go in this direction, positive, so 360 degrees, 720 degrees, and then 720 plus 360, plus 360, plus 360, go on up to infinity, or go this way, minus 360 degree, minus 720, minus 720, minus 360, like that, go on up to minus infinity. Therefore, the domain is minus infinity to plus infinity, but the range value is only minus 1 to plus 1. That is what we have seen in the graph previously, right? See? This is the graph, right? The graph varies from minus 1 to 1 and it goes on. It can be 0 to 2 pi, only one circle we have seen. It can go on repeated. This will be repeated here. This will be repeated in the left direction also. But here this will be varying from minus 1 to 1, right? And this curve will be repeated again between these two values only, right? Okay. And then it will go up because theta can be any value, minus infinity to plus infinity. The cos inverse function will be minus 1 to 1 only, right? Okay. Thanks for watching. I think we will see more on the trigonometry in the next video. Thank you.